tonight. We're going to sing a bunch of songs just about what it means to be a Christian and your walk with the Lord and ups and downs you go through and what it means to overcome them in the Lord, because you can as a believer in Christ. This next song is for all of you Christians who are going to hang on to your belief in God no matter what anyone tells you.
Barbarian, for believing in original sin. They say we're all in one with the universe. surface than what it implies. Assuming that the end justifies the means, no one's looking behind the scenes. I think you should know that God sees everything that you do. There's never a time He's not watching out over you.
Times we get criticized for the type of music we listen to. You know, people think that rock music can't be used for the Lord, but then we criticize a lot of the times the old hymns that you know, our parents were raised with, and say that it's boring and that it's no good anymore. And you know, it goes both ways. If we're going to expect people to accept the kind of music we listen to, we need to be open-minded to a lot of the great songs that came before us, because there were a lot of people who were blessed of the Lord many years ago who wrote songs that were truly inspirational, and we're going to do one of those songs for you. We changed the music a little bit to kind of fit what we're doing these days, but we kept the words the same because they wrote some pretty good words back in those days. And this song is called Sweet By and By.
Bye. on that beautiful shore. The melodious songs of the blessed, and our spirit shall sorrow no more, nor a sigh for the blessing of rest. Where?
By and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
The glorious gift of his love and the blessings that hollow our days.
Sweet by and by, we shall meet on that beautiful shore.
We shall meet on that beautiful shore.
People think that becoming a Christian means that all of a sudden all of your problems are solved. And I'll tell you, the biggest problem of all is solved. The problem of where you're going to spend the rest of your life, your eternal life, that part is solved, and you're going to be with the Lord forever. But you know, while we're still here, we go through a lot of other problems, and it isn't always easy. But the thing is, when you are a child of God, you know that you've got Him on your side. And just to know you've got the Creator of the universe looking out after you, it's a good thing to know, and He's never going to let you down, and you're never going to have to go through anything all by yourself again.
Thank you.
the dark.
You know, all of a sudden, it seems like it's a popular thing to have a religion that you can call your own, and it seems like I'm getting tangled in the microphone stand here. Okay, it seems like, you know, that the Christian religion, because that's what a lot of people are turning it into, the Christian faith actually is becoming the bandwagon that a lot of people want to jump onto. You see a lot of celebrities, a lot of politicians, all of a sudden these days saying that they're born again, that they've had some kind of an experience with God. And I want to tell you, the experience with God you should be looking for is to get to know His Son, Jesus Christ, personally. That's the experience that we're supposed to be looking for. Now, there's all sorts of people out there that have their different methods, they have their ways and all of that, but they're just sorely, they just misunderstand what being Christian means. A lot of people think that saying you're a Christian is all it takes. We're told, though, right in the Bible, that those people will stand before God on the final day, and they'll say, "Didn't we do all these wonderful things in your name?" And He'll tell them that He didn't even know them because they didn't have a relationship with Him. Just saying you're a Christian isn't enough. You've got to live it. And if you are living it, people are going to realize there's a change. They're going to see God living in you. And this next song we're going to do is just about all the people out there that are Christians in name only. And it's called Name Droppers.
Name Droppers.
And the
got a new album coming out hopefully any day now, so might be in the stores in a couple weeks, I don't know, but we're going to do a song for you now that it's going to be the first single off of it. And as Christians, you know, we go through our lives knowing that there is a hope, and sometimes we forget what the hope is. We think, well, we're Christians, we know God, and well, that's it. But you know, eventually we will go to be with the Lord. That's the one thing you got to remember. No matter what you go through, it's all going to seem like nothing when we see him face to face one of these days, and it is going to happen, and it may happen sooner than a lot of us think. That's what this next song is about. It's called Interstellar Satellite.
Sail beyond the
tonight, we're here to let you know tonight that if you don't know the Lord personally, tonight can be your night. You can get to know him. He's there waiting for you. And you know, sometimes, you know, we wonder, well, just what does being a Christian mean? It means turning from your old ways and following the Lord. And, you know, we were told to be imitators of Christ. And so we've got to be more than just believers. You know, we're told in the Bible, even the demons believe and they tremble. We need to be followers of Christ. And you know, everyone is so excited up in heaven. We're told that even when one sinner comes to repentance, that all the angels in heaven are rejoicing over it. And I'll tell you, all of us here would certainly be rejoicing over it if any one of you came to know the Lord tonight. So we just want to encourage you, get to know the Lord personally. He'll have all the angels in heaven rejoicing, you'll have us rejoicing, and you'll be the life of the party.
Can do
one more song for you tonight, and we want to thank you for coming. It's been great being out here. This is the first time we've ever been out this far away from home, and we're not disappointed. From California, quite a ways, but it's well worth it. You're all really nice. We just want to leave you with this one thought, and also to remind you, for any of you who don't know the Lord tonight, or maybe you are a Christian and you kind of let your walk slide with the Lord, there's going to be counselors through those doors over there. If you'd like to talk to them afterwards, they'd be glad to talk to you and lead you in the sinner's prayer, or just pray with you for any problems you might have that you want the Lord to help you with. We want to let you know, sometimes even though you feel like you've done the one thing God can't forgive you for, if you're feeling that tug there for forgiveness, it's the Lord calling you, and he's not going to turn you away. And if you feel, you know, like you want to be forgiven, but you just don't know if God can forgive you, God's going to forgive you. He's not calling you for nothing. So this song is for you.
Johnson, on guitar Dan O'Woolen, and on drums Jimmy Wisner. I'm Stephen Crumbacher, and thanks for coming. God bless you.